Hi, in this Lightboard session, we're going to talk about the 4-inch scope and how you can use it to loop over records. Now, in the typical programming language, there is some equivalent to this. It'll be a for loop or some sort of ability to iterate over something. Now, in Mule terminology, we're talking scopes so that we can put blocks of code inside something. So that's what the 4-inch scope is about. So if you take in a collection, so we've got a collection of records, and we want to do something to each of those records. That's where the for each scope comes in, because you can put a block of code inside a for each and put whatever event processes you want in here, and it will break apart your overall collection and process it for each record. So this will execute that, then this will execute that, and it does this sequentially. So it's a good for the sort of situations where you need to preserve the order of your collection and loop over them doing some action. Now, I should stress though that this is not for doing data transformation. So the end result of the payload after this is whatever you had here. So it's not going to override the structure of this. And if you need to do that, you don't need a for each scope. You use DataWeave and you use a map. So you could do a map function, and that's what DataWeave is about. Taking one structure, running it through a transformation and producing another structure. Now, that is great. The default behavior is great if you need to do something for each individual record. So if you were doing an individual insert into a database, or you were sending a notification to something for each record. But in a lot of cases, you might have a large collection, and to do every single record might not be what you need for your use case. So there is a second mode that you can do with for each, and instead of doing it one by one, you can override the block size or the batch size. And you can say, I want to do this in chunks of, I don't know, 3 records. And what that will do is that, just like before, you put your code in here, but what you should expect inside the for each here is you should get a collection. It won't be the whole collection, it'll be 3 at a time. So you'll have, for the first iteration through, you would have the first 3. So these will then go in there, and then it'll do another, and so on. Okay, and the final one will be whatever's left. Okay, but this is really good if you need to do bulk operations. So you could do a bulk insert. If you were doing a database, if you were going to something like Salesforce, you might do a bulk create rather than an individual create. So really good if you need to minimize your round trips across a network. If you've got 100 records, if you want to do 100 round trips, use the default behavior. If you want to do it in chunks, set the batch size to something and then use bulk operations. And that explains what for each is about.